Moore for Aggie TV, and I'm here outside of Freeborn Hall where I'm about to interview 30 Seconds to Mars. The band started off in 1998 by brothers Jared and Shannon Leto. So I'm here with Shannon, and he is one of the members of 30 Seconds to Mars. So Shannon, tell me about the band right now and what you guys are up to.
Well, we're in Davis. Lovely, lovely Davis. I'm talking to you. Mm-hmm. Getting ready to perform. Mm-hmm. We've been on the road actually since last year of November. And it's finally nice to be playing in the United States. We've been mostly overseas. So
what's going on with your tour? Is there any place that you guys are really looking forward to playing?
Davis tonight.
So how did you guys come up with the band name, 30 Seconds to Mars? Is there a meaning behind it?
You know, it's more, yeah, there's a bunch of meanings behind 30 Seconds to Mars. It came in a dream. And that dream was met by a reality, a book that was found, an old manuscript called the Agoraphobics, and just those two elements combined just made sense to have 30 Seconds to Mars. Ask our fans, they'll tell you what it means.
Definitely.
There's a bunch out there.
Yeah, you have a crazy amount of fans out there. There's been people out there since 11 a.m.
Yeah.
Waiting for you.
Yeah.
Cool.
I can't wait to play for them.
So what can we expect to see from 30 Seconds to Mars in the near future?
Just touring. We're going to be touring till we're done. I mean, till the end of time. till we die. Mm-hmm. We're just going to keep... I mean, if we're inspired to do so, we're going to keep making music, you know, and performing and playing and traveling.
Speaking of music, what influences your guys' songs?
Yeah, there's so many elements. I mean, life experience. Mm-hmm. I mean, all the elements that are the experiences that we go through. I mean, it could be a book, it could be a movie, it could be a conversation, it could be... music, you know, mm-hmm. All those things contribute to the sound.
And how's it touring with your brother?
It's great. I mean, I'm really, really grateful to be touring with my brother. I respect him greatly. He's an amazing artist. He's a hard worker, and his vision is magical. You know, from the videos to the music to everything, I'm a lucky, lucky guy to be touring with them.
So how do you feel about MTV censoring your new video, Hurricane, from their channel and viewers due to the sexually explicit content?
It's kind of funny. I mean, if you look at the other shows that are going on MTV, I think it pales in comparison to the content that's supposed to be provocative, you know. I hear they are playing it now. They are playing it now. I just heard actually today.
Yeah,
the concert. Yeah, yeah. But my first feeling was like it was a little ridiculous, but they have their reasons, mm-hmm. And we respect MTV. We have a great relationship with MTV. So, but they're playing it actually right now, this second.
Really?
This second now, they're playing it. So.
How about the symbols in your band? What do they represent, or is there?
Well, in 30 Seconds to Mars, we've always been interested in not just only creating sounds. We've been interested in all different art forums and expressing ourselves in many ways, artistically, and the visual aspects of 30 Seconds to Mars is just as important as us playing up there on stage.
Definitely.
You know?
Your guys' music videos are more like a story,
yeah,
than just regular music videos.
Yeah. They're like little films, and my brother does an amazing job directing them. So,
yeah.
God, he's a talented mother. Can I say motherfucker?
Go ahead.
It's college. It's college. Motherfucker.
Exactly.
Davis. AGTV. I love you. Thank you. Bye.